devastating news for Canada's economy this week. After months of promising Canadians that he would somehow get the Trans Mountain pipeline under construction this summer, a court has overturned the approvals that this Liberal government gave. So once again, we find out that Trudeau had no plan at all. His disastrous energy policy is costing Canadians billions of dollars and thousands of jobs. And remember, it was Trudeau who killed the Northern Gateway project, which would have brought energy to deep water ports, allowing us to open up to Asian markets. Right now, we get a huge discount because we can only sell to the Americans. He also killed Energy East, a project that would have displaced foreign oil in eastern Canada. Right now, many provinces rely on energy and oil and gas imported from the United States, from Saudi Arabia, from Algeria. Alors, cette semaine, les nouvelles très négatives pour notre économie. Beaucoup de travailleurs sont tellement inquiétés par la décision d'une cour qui a annulé la décision pour le pipeline de Trans Mountain. Ça, c'est une mauvaise développement, pas seulement pour les travailleurs, mais aussi pour les contribuables. This isn't just bad news for Canadian energy workers. It's devastating news as well for Canadian taxpayers. I mean, think about this. Justin Trudeau wrote a check for over $4.5 billion of your tax money to an American company so that they can invest in American projects, competing directly with Canadian projects. This is so frustrating that Trudeau has so mismanaged our energy sector that your tax dollars are going to subsidize American projects. Also, news out of Washington this week, very, very concerning. Les nouvelles de Washington cette semaine avec les discussions, les négociations de l'ALENA. The negotiations around NAFTA, where Canada rejoined it this week. One thing that has become very clear is that there were serious issues decided by the Mexicans and the Americans while Canada wasn't even at the table. That's very alarming for many in Canada. We're waiting and seeing what the full details are, but one thing is very clear, that what Mexico and America and the Americans were deciding were not just bilateral issues. There are many issues that they've come to agreement on that now we're only learning about now. So Conservatives are once again offering our support for NAFTA. This is so important. So many jobs depend on this. We've offered the Liberal government our assistance wherever we can, and we're going to continue doing that. We'll find more about it next week. But once again, when it comes to Trudeau's handling of the energy file, quand on parle de le secteur énergétique, c'est clair que c'est un échec total pour Justin Trudeau. It's a complete and utter failure. Conservatives have been fighting to get our natural resources to market. We've been fighting against the Liberals and their attempts to add new regulatory burdens. Everyone I talk to in the energy sector just says, tell us where the goalposts are and we'll try to meet that. But when the government constantly moves the goalposts back, adding new layers, driving out that investment, all Canadians have to pay for Justin Trudeau's failures. So Conservatives are going to keep up the fight. House of Commons comes back in a couple of weeks, and we're going to be asking Justin Trudeau the tough questions about his handling of these major issues.